Greetings and shalom, brothers and sisters. It's good to see everyone back here today, and what an eventful week it has been this week. I don't know how many people here have been tuning into the news and seeing all the floods, the fires, and everything that's happening. Everyone seeing that? Yeah? And it's shocking because so many people have, like hundreds of people have died from all these events, and it's something that we don't often see in Australia. And for us, it's an amazing thing, and the other good thing is just to see all the generosity of the people out there, people who don't know God but are willing to give for this cause, and I was really touched with everything that happened in regards to that this week. And the amazing thing about these things is that they're prophetic, because Ellen White, in her writings and Spirit of Prophecy, speaks of events like this unfolding in the last days, which would eventually lead to basically the powers that be pointing to God's people as the ones causing these things. But tonight we're going to be taking a look at another aspect of this whole of final events and everything that's occurring in this world. And we're going to be taking an in-depth look at music itself, because I believe that music is going to play a major part in final events in these last days that we're living in. So tonight we're going to take an almost supernatural journey into the mystery of music and what it means for us as religious people, as Christians, and how it may affect us in the future. And Scripture has shown us some amazing things, that little gold nuggets of truth in Scripture that the Lord has left there for us to let us know about these things, so we will not be left in darkness. But before we begin that, what I want to do tonight is I just want to show you briefly, just a little brief clip that I put together this week. It just shows a bit of my old lifestyle and where I came from. And I do not air this just to give glory to myself in any way whatsoever, but I do have a point that I want to prove in a second and show you. So we'll just watch this clip.
Thank you.
Well, that was a bit of the G-rated, you could say, of my old life. And the thing about that lifestyle is, even though I wasn't there, I inserted a few different clips there to do with the music industry and those who actually claim to have occult connections with that scene. And I included that in there because once anyone who goes into the secular music industry, doesn't matter what good intentions, even as being a Christian, if you have good intentions to go into that, there is no way that you can avoid being led astray. But there was another more important point I wanted to get out of that. The music that you heard then, what were you feeling when you heard that? Were you feeling relaxed? Yeah. A sense of evil, as this gentleman said. I want to show you another clip as well.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, one way. Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, to my knees or will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine.
Clip make you feel? Did it make you feel like you were evil or scary or nothing, or was it really touching? Touching, yeah. All right, I'll show you one more example.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me.
Are you getting my point here? You see, the reason I showed these three clips is because a lot of people in any culture, in our culture, in our church, think that music doesn't have power within itself. They think that you can take any kind of lyrics, and as long as it's Christian lyrics, then it's okay. But tell me, isn't it amazing just how in that last clip, where once you might have seen it as being evil, suddenly it turned into being good, just through the power of music? Now, I'd just like to quickly recap on everything we've learned so far. So far, we've taken a journey from the 1960s, and we've had a look at all these rock stars and all these people that started up the music industry and started out, made it successful, and most of these groups claim